Well, a hearty shalom to you, a Sabbath of peace. It's easier to say that than it is to feel that for many, I know, as we all find ourselves somewhat hemmed in. I mention that because we're stuck. We're at home, keeping social distance, and we're not gathering together as a community of faith. And, you know, just the nature of things in the moment, we can be unrested. It's hard to have Sabbath peace when we feel unrested in our hearts owing to uncertainty about the times. I get all that. I'm sensitive to that. I live in the world like the rest of us do, but I also, you know, live in the Word. And I live, I'm from a covenant people that's been around for thousands of years. Hebrews have experienced the, you know, the rise and demise of our nation state in Israel, plagues, persecutions, so many nations have come at us, and you know, we're here after thousands of years. It's a testament to the fact that God watches over his word to perform it. And that's not just true for Jews, that's true for you, it's for everybody, truth be known, that at times like this, I can, you know, fix my gaze on something beyond the circumstance. Not that I make light of the circumstance. You know, as you know, I, in addition to being a religious leader, am also engaged in a secular vocation. I get to take my faith and put it to practice out there in the world, and I serve as a peace officer, principally as an administrator at the police academy, but I'll be heading out in the streets. I signed up for a couple shifts to go out there and work some of these stations where people go to get tested. And so, you know, I'm out there in the world trying to do my little part. In addition to needing to hem myself in from the world and do my part with the rest of you, as we together just look to ride out this storm. I believe that we are going to ride out the storm, quite frankly. My heart isn't filled with trepidation. Using this time, and I hope you're using the time, by the way, to you know, get closer to family, study a little more, get into the Word a little more, or you know, whatever it is that you can just kind of, you know, polish your own mind. I think reading does to the brain what weightlifting does to the body. I'm working out more, you know, I'm keeping it at all. So I hope that you're keeping about your life best you can and not just throwing your hands up in despair and not just, you know, overdoing a fear associated with all this. Let's just all be cautious and together we'll find a way to get through it. Some new innovations are going to be rolling out with Sar Shalom, new mechanisms for communication. I'll be sending that out electronically, so you'll have links and you'll see ways that we're doing our video, ways that we're doing something of a newsletter. It's a way to build community, the more so, and that will exist beyond this current state of affairs that we as a culture find ourselves in. So there'll be some new innovations that come out of this. I should say as well that when the plague hit Cambridge centuries ago, when people were quarantined, Isaac Newton came up with laws of motion there and made other monumental contributions to the laws of physics, making the most of the time as he found himself somewhat hemmed in. This week's Torah reading is in Exodus chapter 35 through 40, and this is dealing with particulars associated with the tabernacle. We read earlier in chapter 25, there was the call to take an offering to help build the tabernacle. And I want to pick up in chapter 35, verse 20, to see where people actually picked up on that. There's a beautiful picture in here that I want to underscore, and I don't have a lot of time because with bandwidth, or I think that's the term, I'm not very electronically savvy. You know, I can't give long talks because even if I give an 8 or 9 minute talk, it can take 2 or 3 hours to upload it till I can get the link. So good for you. I can't talk long. In chapter 35, verse 20, then all the congregation of Bnei Israel departed from before Moses, everyone whose heart stirred him and everyone whose spirit was willing came and brought Adonai's offering to the work, for the work of the tent of meeting and for all the service as well as for the holy garments. Now, he says all the men, but the women, you'll see, is, they're particularly proactive and participating as well. I love it that people walk away from something and there's something inside of them that's stirred. Their heart stirs them. Their heart inclines them to go invest in the development of this worship space. There's something beautiful in that, and I mention that because, you know, people visit a Messianic congregation, that's nice. And they come once or twice and you never see them again. They're not bad people. It's just that their heart doesn't stir them that direction. I mention that because I work in television as well, and hundreds of thousands of people watch the program Our Jewish Roots. It airs on Daystar a couple times a week and Trinity Broadcasting Network. Good time slots. And people see it and they go, oh, that's interesting, that's insightful. They might even say that's important, but their heart doesn't stir them. That doesn't mean they're bad people. I just mentioned there's certain people, their hearts are stirred by what we're all about, that is wanting to connect the Jesus story and the Jewish story, not just intellectually. You know, as a professor, people go, oh, that's interesting. That helps me to connect the dots. And I'm glad to be able to participate in inculcating new ways of understanding for people that are going to be pastors and missionaries. Similarly, on television, people go, oh, that's interesting. It helps me to connect the dots. I'm glad that it facilitates deeper Bible study. But for people like us, it's not just that. It is that, but it's more, because we're looking to develop some kind of community around this sort of thing, and that's really novel. I know for me, I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, you know, Jeff, I really want to do this. I want to help with this emergent Messianic Jewish experience. And I want to thank you, by the way, for going with me on the journey. I mean that sincerely, and I don't hold it against those that aren't inclined, but particularly for those whose heart stirs them a little bit this way, I just want to say thank you for turning this way. I know all you can do is look at a video screen right now, a computer screen, and see a clip, and I look forward to seeing you in person, and that'll come soon in short order. Barry gives her blessings. We love you in the Lord and look forward to seeing you soon. God bless. Bye-bye.